Okay, now we'll start with the unbalanced assignment problems. Take this problem. Problem number three is three jobs are to be produced by four machines. Three jobs are to be produced by four machines. Each job can be assigned to one and only one machine. That is actually assignment problem. One and only one machine. The cost of each job on each machine is given in the following table. The given in table shows that the cost. So for first job, what is the cost if you process on the machine one and machine two, machine three, machine four, like that they are given. And last one, what are the job assignments which will minimize the total cost? What are the job assignments which will minimize the total cost? Okay, by seeing this statement, we can say that again it is the minimization matrix. So minimization problem. Now, how to solve this one? So what is the first step? A first step is we need to check whether the given problem having the same number of rows and columns. So okay, this what is the order of the matrix m cross n? What is that? Number of rows are 3 and number of columns are 4. So it means that it is having the deficiency, so that we need to add a one dummy row because it is having the one less row. So that's why we need to add one dummy row. Okay, write down the solution. So first step is check given problem having n is equal to m, but in this case n is not equal to m, so that's why we need to make n equal to m. Just write that matrix n equal to m, or else, so let me finish the problem so later you can write it n equal to m by adding zeros. Okay, now after that we're supposed to go for this second step. That is, what is the second step? That is a row minimization. So what is the row minimization? So we need to check in each row which is the least number, and subtract that number in the all the elements. Okay, now, and it's not, and in the previous class also I explained that it is not compulsory that we are supposed to go for the row minimization only first. Even you can go for the column minimization also. In this problem, a column iteration is not required because that fourth row having all the zeros, all the elements are zero. It means that each column having the zeros already. So if you skip that step number 3, that's also fine. Okay, now a row iteration. So what is the minimum number? A least number in the first row. What is the least number? 18 is the least number. Okay, 18 minus of 18 is 0. Next one, 24 minus of 18 is 6. 28 minus of 18 is 10. 32 minus 18 is 14. Okay, we are finished with the first row. And for the second row, 8 is the minimum. Again, it's 8 minus 8 is 0. 13 minus of 8 is 5. 17 minus of 8 is 9. 19 minus of 8 is 11. Okay, we have finished with the second row also. And in the third row, 10 is the minimum. Okay. 10 is the minimum. 10 minus of 10. Is 12. 0, 5, 5, 12. And the last row is same. Okay, now we should not go for the column iteration. So column iteration is not required in this problem because, so before proceeding to the column iteration, you need to check whether each column having the zeros or not. If there is a zeros are present in each column, even though if you do the column iteration, again you will get the same answer because the zero itself is the least number in that column. So that zeros will be subtracted from each element. Okay, now once we finish with the row iteration and the column iteration, then we need to go for the assigning. Okay, what is our step? How to assign that? So we need to check each row and each column. So which is having the least number? Okay, it's a fantastic problem. That is, so each row having the single zeros and each columns also having the single zeros. So in that case, if you assign to anyone, you just listen to me, if you assign to this first one, then all these will be cancelled. Next one, if you assign to this one, then these will be cancelled. Okay, we are done with only two. So J1 to M1 and J4 to M2. M2 assignment. What about others? What about others? So already in the previous problems, we have checked that. So how to get the optimum stage? If small n equal to capital N, if small n equal to capital N, then we can say that, okay, this last statement, you can check that. A sixth step is at the end, check n equal to N. So what is the small n? What is the capital N? Capital N is number of assigned. And small n is either number of rows or the number of columns. If it is not equal, then we need to proceed. If it is equal, then we can say that we are finished with the problem. Okay, here a small n is that is the number of rows or the columns are 4. What about the number of assignments? That is only 2. It means that we need to proceed with the next stage. So we are not reached the optimum stage. Now we need to proceed for that. Okay, I hope you have taken this. Okay, after that, we need to proceed with these steps. Okay, steps to follow in assignment. If number of allocations are not equal to the number of rows or the number of columns, that is, if small n is not equal to the capital N, either this n may be of m also, because in the assignment problem we are using the square matrix. Okay, if it is not equal, then what is the first step? Well, first step is draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines. Draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines which covers all zeros. So try to understand that statement. Draw minimum number of horizontal as well as the vertical lines which covers all zeros. And second one is identify. Okay, once you finish off with the drawing the line, so then you need to identify a least number from uncovered or the unstriked element. You need to remember all these steps. If you make a little bit mistake, then your answer will not be correct. Then identify a least number from uncovered or the unstriked element. Third one is subtract that least number from all uncovered elements. Subtract that least number from all uncovered element. And next one, add that least number to all the intersections. So intersection means if there is a vertical line as well as the horizontal line, then that is the intersection. So that intersection we can add it and solve with the usual method by assigning to zeros. If again number of allocations is not equal to number of columns or zeros, then repeat from step 1 to again till. Okay, now here, so there is one question, that is, what about that crossed line? So if you are striked, so we have used the only unstriked, uncovered lines, uncovered and intersection. What about the only striked line? So we should not touch anything to that strike. Okay, now I hope you have taken these steps. Draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines and identify least number. Subtract that least number from uncovered, add that least number to all the intersections. So if you want, you can write it, don't touch anything or don't make any alteration. Don't make any alteration to striked elements. Striked in the sense, so if you draw on the horizontal or vertical line on that element, so that is a strike. So we should not change either subtract or the addition, so should not be done. This is the way we need to follow. Okay, now okay, I'll proceed with the next step. Okay, for that I need to take the second this matrix I need to take You know, we need to write all the numbers. No, we need to write all the numbers. Okay, what is the first one? All zero, 6, 10, 14. Five, nine, 11, 9, 11, 12. Okay, this is the matrix, so which we got in the previous step. Okay, after this matrix, we didn't get all the assignment. We got only two assignments, but the number of rows or the number of columns are four. Okay, now we need to draw a line. We need to draw a line, horizontal line or the vertical line. Which cross all the zeros. So that number of lines should be minimum. So you can say that, okay, I'll draw all the horizontal line. 1, 2, 3, 4. It should not be. Try to draw number of lines are lesser than number of rows or the number of columns. That's why we need to draw one vertical line here. So we need to draw one vertical line. Next one, we need to draw the horizontal line. Okay, this is the first step. We need to draw the first step is draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines which covers all zeros. So we have covered all the zeros. After that, identify least number from uncovered element. From uncovered. Okay, from uncovered element. So which is the least number? 5. So first step is completed, and the second step, 5 is the least number. 5 is the least number. Okay, we have identified 5 is the least number. What is the third step? Subtract that least number from all uncovered elements. Okay, we need to write the matrix again. We need to write the matrix again. Subtract that least number from all uncovered. So, okay, for this, it will be 6 minus 5, 5 minus 5, 5 minus 5, 5 minus 5, 12 minus 5. So these are all the uncovered. So these are all the uncovered. So we need to subtract that and subtract and write the numbers. 6 minus 5 is 1, 10 minus 5, 5, 14 minus 5, 9, 5 minus 5 is 0, 4, 6. I hope I'm clearly audible. It is 0. Even it is also 0. Okay, we have finished with the third step also. Subtract that least number from all uncovered elements. Okay, now we're supposed to go for add that least number at all the intersections. Don't make any alteration to the striked element. Okay, how many intersections are there? There is only one intersection at J4M1. This is only the one intersection. That's why we need to add that. We need to add that number, and do not make any changes to the all other striked numbers. Okay, it will be 5. Will be 5, and do not make any changes to the striked numbers. I hope it's clear. You know, I'll make little changes in the colors. Okay, this is we have subtracted, and I added at the intersection. And no changes to the other zero. So any doubts in this? Likewise, we need to form the matrix. Okay, now we can go for the assigning. You can compare the previous matrix. So now we are having the more number of zeros. I hope we can get the answer now. Okay, for assigning, we need to check which row or the column has the least number of zeros. A fourth column having only one zero. Okay, all are same. All are same. So you can assign to anyone because that J4 having the three zeros. Okay, by okay, you can assign to anyone. If you assign to this M1, if you assign to this M1, then it will be cancelled. Then okay, second J3 M3 we can assign. If you assign J3 M3, then these two will be cancelled. Again, this problem may be having the n number of solutions. Again, this problem having the n number of solutions. Okay, no other option. Okay, likewise we can assign. After that, we need to write the answer, that is J1, J2, J3, and J4. Which machines we have assigned? M1, M2, M3, and M4. And that what is the cost? That cost also we need to write. What is the cost they are given? 18, 13, 15. 18, 13, 15, and last one is 0 because that is the extra dummy we have added. 15, how much it is? 13, sorry, 30 plus 46. This is the final answer. Likewise, we need to solve the unbalanced type of assignment problem. Okay, in a glance, I will explain about the how to solve the unbalanced type of assignment problem. So first, once if we get the matrix, we need to check the whether the given matrix is having the number of rows and number of columns equal or not. If it is not equal, then we need to make it equal by adding zeros. Sorry, by adding either dummy row or the dummy column. After that, you need to go for the row iteration or the column iteration. Okay, in this problem, the column iteration is not required because each one, the dummy row having the zeros in all the columns, so need not to go for column iteration. Then for the row iteration, so identify the least number from each row and subtract from all the elements. Once you finish with the first, second and third step, then you need to go for the assigning. By assigning in to the problem, so we got the only two allocations, two assignments. After that, so for the optimality, we need to check the whether the given problem, whether the assignments having the small n equal to capital N. If it is not equal, then we need to proceed for drawing the another steps. If it is not equal, then so we need to follow these steps. So first is draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines which covers all zeros. And we need to draw the number of lines that should be lesser than the number of row or the number of column because both are same. They always it should be less. And the second step is identify the least number from the uncovered cells. That is the important uncovered cells. So least number from uncovered cell. That least number should be subtracted from all the uncovered cells and it should be added at the intersection. Intersection in the sense, so where that vertical line and the horizontal line get intersect. And don't make any changes to the striked elements. It means that if you cross the single line on any one element, then do not make any changes. Keep those value as it is. Solve with the usual method by assigning to zeros. Again, you need to check whether you have the small n equal to capital N. If it is equal, then you can say that we have reached the optimum stage. Otherwise, proceed with the step number one. Again, we need to proceed with the step number one. Okay, with this introduction, we need to draw that line. So here, some people will say that, so I'll draw the all the four horizontal lines, J1, J2, J3, J4. That is not a correct way. Try to draw the minimum number of lines. That line should be lesser than the number of row or the number of column. Okay, here we have drawn the F1 and J4 line. After that, you need to identify the which is the least number from uncovered cells. That is a 5 is the least number. That 5 should be subtracted from all the uncovered that I have written with the red font in the next matrix. Next one at the intersection. So this J4 M1 is the intersection element. So that's why we need to add here. So 0 plus of 5 will be that addition. And do not change or do not make any alteration to the just drawn covered lines. After that, go for assigning with the usual method. At the end, we need to write the answer like it. Like this way, we can solve the unbalanced assignment problem.